karaoke competition on the Saturday show this weekend. Who will be singing for us a little bit later? I wonder. Now it's over to Newsround with Lizo.
This is Newsround. Hi, welcome to the programme. Our top stories this afternoon. It's S Club 6 as Paul quits. Plus, fancy a bite? Check out the biggest bun ever made. Hi, first there were 7, now there's only 6. Despite topping the charts and stashing the cash, Paul Catamol has decided to go it alone and leave S Club 7. The rest of the band say they'll carry on as normal, but is the S Club party now over? S Club 7 have sold millions of records, bagged loads of awards and made tons of cash. The cheery clubbers have bounced their way to the top, so why is Paul leaving?
I think that he's probably going to miss the other people that he has been singing with.
I don't think it'll make much difference because I think the boys were more dancers and the girls did all the singing, so I think they'll be fine without him.
Well, recently he's been looking really bored and has now finally admitted that he's just not interested in pop anymore. Instead, Paul's getting heavy. He's leaving S Club 7 to make new metal music with his old school band called Skua. He says, I've reached a point in my life where I'd like to experiment in different types of music as a solo artist. I love S Club to bits and I know they'll continue to be hugely successful. I'll be watching them every step of the way and wish them all the best. So no more Paul, what about the rest of the band? Well, they're going to keep moving to the funky, funky beat. They're not going to replace him, they're just going to knock off the 7 to become S Club.
I don't think he'll make it as a solo singer because they've been together for so long. I think he won't be able to take everything on his own.
They might carry on or they might just slip down a bit.
But the rest of the band are still smiling. They've just signed a new record deal for £1 million each. Now, losing a band member often spells trouble for the rest of the group. Dan Cleef from Top of the Pops magazine, you've seen it all before. What's going to happen to S Club now that Paul's gone?
Well, I think obviously they're very upset that Paul's leaving, but I don't think it's going to affect the success they've received. As you said, they've just signed a massive deal for £1 million each, so the record companies obviously believes that there's a lot of success for them still to have. I think they're going to go on and do great things. Obviously, they're not going to be called S Club 7 anymore, but I think they'll do really well. And we've seen recently with bands like Hearsay, it can upset the apple cart a little bit when a member leaves, but S Club have been very strong and I'm sure they'll do really well.
So you've got faith they'll do brilliantly in the future?
Yeah, lots of faith.
Now what about Paul's chances as a solo artist if the band are going to be fine?
Well, it really does vary. I mean, we've seen with a band like Take That, Robbie Williams left the band and went on to do massive things. With the Spice Girls, Jerry left and did really well, as did Mel C, but the other members haven't done so well. Doesn't really guarantee it, and Paul's being quite bold in that he's going for a very different style of music. We've yet to see whether people are going to accept that, but I think, you know, hopefully he'll do really well. I wish him the best.
Oh. Dan Cleef from Top of the Pops magazine, thank you very much for joining us this afternoon. On to other news, and today saw one of Britain's biggest ever motorway pileups. More than 100 vehicles were involved in 2 accidents along the M40 in Oxfordshire. 4 people died and thousands of cars were stuck in traffic queues. Aid is starting to arrive in northern parts of Afghanistan, devastated by 2 days of earthquakes.